Hey everyone, welcome back to Arts Core. I would like to thank Ninja Spectrum or Vedant for suggesting this video. Before we begin, a small notice. The following methods that I'll be showing are not the only ways of doing realistic drawing. These are just some tricks I use and thought will be very helpful for beginners. A common mistake is when artists draw their guidelines or sketches super dark. This prevents the drawing from having a realistic effect and it leans more towards a cartoony effect. Instead, we want to draw the basic sketch lightly and then darken up only the borders that are needed. This will also make it easy to erase the guidelines if you make a mistake. As you can see, even after erasing, the guidelines are still visible on the left side, while on the right side, they're close to invisible. When shading, there are a couple of things to keep in mind. First, avoid huge gaps between each stroke. Second, do not apply uneven pressure. This will result in different shades of strokes, making some darker and some lighter. Also, it will make it very difficult to blend. The third thing is to not shade in random directions. Instead, what we want to do is shade in the same direction as the area we are covering. For example, the rim on the top is curved, so I will be shading in curved strokes. Also, as you can see, there is a little distance between each stroke and all the strokes have the same darkness. It is not like there are some random dark lines in the middle. When blending, do not blend with your fingers. This will not give an even blend and you will have less control. Instead, use a tissue, a brush, or a blender, also called a paper stump. Here is an example of using a brush, and you can see the difference between the two drawings. A common mistake people make when using paper stump is by not separating the different values, or the light and dark areas. They also tend to move the paper stump back and forth and in different directions, causing the area to be all the same color. Instead, what you want to do is shade in the darker areas and then blend towards the lighter ones. Move the paper stump in the same direction as the strokes you have made earlier to have a smooth and even transition. As mentioned earlier, values are the light and dark areas. A lot of people either shy away from the dark areas or make the entire drawing using only dark shades. Both these will not give a nice realistic look because there is not enough contrast. For example, here you can see that the darkness of the rim is showing because the area inside the glass is shaded lightly. For the highlight, I suggest you do not add the highlight using an eraser after shading in a section. This does not give a realistic effect because it is very difficult to remove all the graphite. Instead, you should mark out the highlights beforehand and work around them as you shade and blend. This would help make the highlights stand out and show a nice contrast between the light and dark areas. The one thing to remember is that most shadows do not have crisp edges, so drawing solid lines will ruin the effect, and also for darker areas, do not press hard. Instead, lightly shade in the shadow area, and then make layers for the darker areas. Then use any of the three blending tools to blend it out. This way, there will not be any sharp edges or harsh lines. If you still feel like you need to add some more darker areas, make layers using your pencil, and then continue blending. And that is it for this video. I hope you guys learned something. Also, please like the video and hit that subscribe button. Do check out my other videos for more art content. Thank you!